The really fascinating thing about this cat is that they quack like ducks. So that's, I think, the funniest thing about the species. Hi, my name is Anya Ratnayakar and I am the founder of the Urban Fishing Cat Conservation Project. I work with the fishing cat, which is a small wild cat that's found in Sri Lanka. It's also found in South and Southeast Asia, so countries like India, Nepal, Bangladesh, Pakistan, Cambodia, Thailand, places like that. The species is about the size of a street dog that you get here on the streets of Colombo and other areas of the country. They're pretty stocky animals, so a male would be about 15 kilos and a female would be about 8. They look like little leopards, so lots of people think that they are little leopards when they see them. They've also got these three stripes that run down from their forehead and down their backs. They're an amazing cat, and as their name suggests, they're great at catching fish. They're not afraid of swimming underwater and grabbing them as well. Population that I study in Colombo is really unique because fishing cats are generally wetland habitat species, so they're generally found in areas that are really rich with water, so basically wetlands, mangroves, places like that. So Colombo's really lucky because it was basically founded on a wetland, so we've still got a really good rich network of wetlands in the city. About 15% of the city is covered in wetlands. So because of that, we've got a really nice population of fishing cats here. But unfortunately, because of all the urbanization and the development that's happening, some of our wetlands are being cleared for various reasons, and luckily for us, the government has taken an initiative to start protecting and rehabilitating these wetlands. So when I graduated from the University of Queensland, I returned home, and like any young wildlife biologist in Sri Lanka, I wanted to work with the Sri Lankan leopard because it's this big, cool, amazing looking cat, right? But then while I was writing my proposal for my leopard project, a colleague of mine said that a friend of hers, a vet, was looking after an orphan fishing cat that was given to her by the wildlife department for hand rearing. So of course, because I wanted to procrastinate, I rushed over to her house, and she took me into this room and she told me to sit down really quietly in a corner, which I did. And from under the bed, I saw these two little yellow glowing eyes. And within 5 minutes, this adorable, incredible looking animal that looked like a leopard ran out with a purple sock dangling from its mouth, and it dropped it on my lap. And it wanted me to basically toss this soggy, wet, spitty sock across the room so that he could fetch it. I learned that that was a fishing cat. That was the first time I'd ever heard of the species. I did not know that they existed. So after spending a couple of hours playing with this cat, I returned home, I deleted my leopard project, and I started studying the fishing cat. Through my project, we capture and collar fishing cats, with Wildlife Department permission, of course. And we track their movements for a period of 12 months. So the data that we get, we can understand how the cats are moving through the city, how they're getting from one wetland to the other, and the information that we collect, we can feed into government stakeholders like the Wildlife Department and the Sri Lanka Land Reclamation and Development Corporation, so that they can integrate this information into their wetland management protocol. The process that we go through to find fishing cats in a habitat is quite simple, but it's a bit lengthy. So what we first do is we first go around the wetland and we look for signs. So basically we look for footprints or we look for scat. Scat means poop. Usually footprints and scat is the closest we would ever get to a fishing cat in the wild, because they're extremely, extremely good at playing hide and seek, which is very frustrating as a researcher. The next thing we do is, once we've confirmed that there is fishing cats, cat and footprints, is that we set up camera traps around the wetlands in certain areas. So these cameras are remote, so it's not like the DSLR. It's a little remote box that is triggered by movement. So we set them up everywhere, and we monitor these camera traps and make sure that a fishing cat has walked past. If there are fishing cats in the area and we've got photo evidence confirming this, then we, along with Wildlife Department, we set trap cages in selected areas and trap fishing cats. Once we've got a fishing cat in our trap, then the Wildlife Department comes and we proceed to sedate the animals and fix the GPS collars around their necks. These GPS collars basically allow us to see where the fishing cat goes on a 24-hour basis. So for about 12 months, every day, we're going to get data from our cats. Right now, we've got two cats that have been collared. One of them has given us a lot of data. And over the past 2 months, we have over 4,600 GPS points of this cat moving, not just in this Diasaru Park, but in the surrounding habitats as well. So if you see a fishing cat in the wild, whether in Colombo or out of Colombo, watch it from afar. Don't really approach it or try and pet it, because like all animals or even us, you'll get bitten. Look at it from afar, enjoy the sighting. And if you do see one, please get onto our website. It's called save.cat, and mark the location with your information so that we could add it to our distribution map, because we're trying to understand where the cats are in the country. And to learn more, you can always visit our website, which is fishingcats.lk.